So, welcome back. Today we talk about Erased Tapes Records. Erased Tapes Records was founded, I think, around 2007 in London and is a label which is on the side of the neoclassical avant-garde electronic music with quite some outstanding artists, Niels Frahm, Olafur Arnalds, and on. Great recordings, great musicians, great music, beautiful editions, not on the audiophile side, but still decent, good pressings in general, and very worthwhile your time and your effort to get, if you aren't already, a bit into. When it comes to this neoclassical music, for me it's very hard to talk about the music itself, you know. It's like dancing your name. How can I describe, or how can one describe, neoclassical avant-garde electronic music? So please consider this only as recommendations of artists who are into this genre and worthwhile getting more or deeper into them. So let's just start with the first artist, and this artist is my favorite of this label, and he is my favorite vibraphonist. He is called Masayoshi Fujita, Japanese artist, outstanding records. It's so beautiful. It's unbelievable interesting to hear this guy. This album is called Book of Life. A little bit hard to get nowadays, but very worthwhile. Highly, highly recommended if you are a bit into this vibraphonists or this kind of music, avant-garde and vibraphonists. Very, very highly recommended. Masayoshi Fujita. I have put out 4 of his albums for this video so that you have a little variety of titles to choose out. Next one is Apologies. I don't know how to pronounce it right. Again, Erased Tapes. Again, Masayoshi Fujita. Fantastic. Fantastic album of a gorgeous musician. The third album on Erased Tapes from him I show you today is Memories of the Wind. Also the cover art is beautiful. You know, this cover art from him, it gives you a good feeling, in a way, of what to expect. Very nice, very beautiful. And not the ordinary music you might expect. The fourth album from him is a collaboration with Jan Jelinek. Jan Jelinek is a German avant-garde musician. And this one is not from Erased Tapes. This is from the Fatish label, from Jan Jelinek. But again, fantastic recording and very interesting. Masayoshi Fujita and Jan Jelinek. It's called Schaum. Schaum is a German word, by the way. And now for other artists. And maybe we start with this edition. White on white. Yeah. This is called 1+1=10. Comes with a little booklet. And this is a very good opportunity to get into this Erased Tapes label. I just read the first line, so you know what to expect from this edition. It's 1+1=10. Sees Erased Tapes artists come together to make an album as a collective, sharing the same space, instruments, and each other's capabilities during a residency in Berlin. It was recorded between 2016 and 2017. Very interesting, beautiful, beautiful album. Gives you a great overview over the artists from Erased Tapes. The next one I would love to show you is an album from Olafur Arnalds. again, this one is one of these neoclassical artists. Very atmospheric, calming, beautiful, beautiful music. This album is called Eulogy for Evolution. Comes with this finally beautiful obi. Well done, well made, beautiful. Very interesting album. Olafur Arnalds, Eulogy for, give me a second, I have lost myself here. Eulogy for Evolution, excuse me. Olafur Arnalds. Next artist, next album is, and I have several of him, maybe the main, the most popular artist here from Germany, Berlin, Niels Frahm. This is his solo, so-called solo album. Does a lot of piano works, again, neoclassical music. Niels Frahm's Frahm Encores 2. You know, these covers, they really mirrors the music very well. Very sophisticated, beautiful in the detail, but calm and not crying out. Very beautiful music. Niels Frahm, Encores 2. Next, Niels Frahm is Juno reworked. It's Juno is to my knowledge is a movie score, music for a movie, and this is the reworked version. Again, beautiful. I have a terrible dent here. Damn it. And also a collaboration between those two guys, between Olafur Arnalds and Niels Frahm. I think they recorded it within one night. They just played together and put the outcome on this beautiful, gorgeous recording. Next artist is Lubomir Melnik. Again, neoclassical music. Look at that cover. Painting, by the way. Beautiful. Album is called Fallen Trees. Same here, you have this neoclassical geniuses at their best. Great recordings. Try it out if you haven't already. Erase Tapes, Lubomir Melnik, Fallen Trees. A bit more on the avant-garde electronic sides are the Rival Consoles. This album is called Persona. Great cover again. Double album as in gatefold. Rival Consoles Persona. Beautiful. So, and the next one is Daniel Brandt Channels. This is again a bit more on the avant-garde side, neoclassical, avant-garde electronic. Interesting listening from Daniel Brandt, comes with a beautiful booklet. They really put a lot of effort into their releases, and they are priced very, very, very decent, around 20 euros per release. So not on the very expensive side. Daniel Brandt Channels. So, and then let's do quick two other releases from Erased Tapes. This one is David Alred, The Transition. David Alred again is on the neoclassical avant-garde side of the musical spectrum. Another interesting artist from Erased Tapes. And the last one for today is Michael Price, Tender Symmetries. Beautiful recording, again on the avant-garde electronic ambient neoclassical side. Again comes with a beautiful booklet with photographs, and you can see how much love and craftsmanship they put into their releases. So this was it with the Erased Tapes. A little break from the jazzy audiophile thing. Again, a little break from the top 10 lists or top 20 lists, which will be the theme of the weekend. So I hope you also enjoy this kind of those kind of videos. And thank you for your time once more, and see you soon. Bye. Thank you.